going on, guys, and welcome back to another video. I do feel like what I'm gonna say in this video will kind of make, I guess, people just not really like my opinion as a whole, but I just feel like it's super important to just talk about this specifically because it's just getting worse, I guess you could say. So we got a ton of stuff to talk about regarding the Avengers game, and there's also this new rumor that it was apparently real at first about basically Insomniac Games removing that whole Avengers, I guess, speech you could say, when Spider-Man goes past the tower and so forth. So we got a lot of stuff to talk about regarding that, but I do want to mention two things. The first thing is that I have started a second channel, and it's more towards you guys that just are interested in, I guess, doing online businesses, side hustles, etc. We got tons of content coming your way, so if you can subscribe to that channel, we also got the first video out there as well. That would be incredible. I am co-hosting on it, so there should be more content, so go ahead, check out the link in the description below. On top of that, I am continuing the giveaway that I do with Instant Gaming every single month, where you can win a game of your choice. So if you haven't yet entered for this month, go ahead, visit that link as well in the description below, and select a game of your choice and be in for the chance to win it. Now, diving into this video, another thing I should ask you guys as well is, have you got your hands on the next gen consoles right now? And if so, let me know in the comments below which one you are playing on, or if you haven't, let me know which one you are going to be getting. But diving into the information, we of course got a new update for Marvel's Avengers yesterday, and I really feel, you know, like from a consumer point of view, that even reading the patch notes and so forth are just feeling repetitive. It just feels like there's nothing really new. And when we go over to the patch notes and so forth, it's just the same thing. All the time, I feel, at this moment in time, it's just fixes after fixes after fixes. But one thing that I notice is that majority of the fixes that they did state all starts with fixed a rare issue. So it kind of bugs me from a consumer, you know, perspective, because a lot of people are talking about Anthem even more recently now, actually saying that, sadly, you know, whether we like to say it or not, it is indeed going that way, because in terms of focusing on new content, it's basically being distracted by having to fix, you know, bugs in the game that shouldn't have really been there. But where I feel like on these blogs it says that they are fixing rare issues, I just kind of feel like if it's a rare issue, should it really still have to delay the future content for this game, if you see what I mean? In the, I guess, smart sense, yes, fixing all problems are going to be key, but I feel like even when they do implement the new content and overall more stuff into the game, you're still naturally going to get bugs, right? It's a live service game. It's almost going to be unavoidable to have a smooth sailing game throughout the entirety of its lifetime, right? So that's one thing that I feel the need to question. And you guys know I support these devs a lot, but with that said, it's just, again, I keep having to say, from a consumer perspective, just looking worrying for the game, and it kind of really frustrates me as well that we just don't have anything. And there was even in the notes as well that they fixed a problem where, of course, people were getting contents of the cloning lab implemented into their game now. So it just looks incredibly crazy. Also talking about the loss that the game had as well, it's just sadly not profitable, and it really, really is sad news. That alone, you guys know we spoke about that a couple of days. And I know some people have agreed with me on this because I posted it in my community tab, but I know there's a handful of people that don't agree when I say this, but it's basically that I feel this game should have been a free-to-play game. Hands down, no doubt about it, it should have just been a free-to-play game, because at this moment in time, I guess there's no profit towards the game, they're at a loss, so it almost makes no sense. One thing that really bugged me is that with the update yesterday, the marketplace prices for the suits went back to normal, and that, it just, again, a consumer point of view, it just looks like their core focus is, of course, the marketplace. And it's really sad to see, because, again, you guys know I'm supporting these devs all the way, but if they know the player numbers are dropping and people were happy with 50% off, although they never said they were permanently going to keep it for things like legendary suits, I just feel like that would have been a no-brainer, because the suits were ridiculously expensive anyway. At least in my opinion, I'm not going to spend that many dollars on a suit. And again, just a personal opinion, but going on the state of the game, I just couldn't see why I would do that, why I would continue throwing money at the game where we're just not getting that new content. We're not even seeing glimpses of new content, which I feel like is the worst at this moment in time. So that's one thing. The second thing is, like I said, it should have just been a free-to-play game, and I would have much rather preferred that if it was a free-to-play game, we then just straight up play for the DLC content in this game. You can even possibly keep the marketplace the same it is with the prices of the legendary skins, because the whole game is free, right? So that would have been great, because again, I wouldn't have been too bothered of the fact with all the glitches and so forth that are in the game, because I haven't paid for the game, right? So that would be one thing. But then when it comes down to DLC content, it'd be exciting to purchase, and you feel like you're actually buying new content anyway. So that, I feel, could have actually, from a business perspective, been a lot more profitable for the devs as a whole, rather than the situation that they're in right now that I don't feel is improving whatsoever. You guys know I passionately talk about the next gen release, right, and how it's going to be their opportunity to revive the game and relaunch it. I still do believe in that, but I mean, heck, right, when it comes down to that stuff, I still think they should just launch as a free to play if that's even possible. And for the current players, what I'm about to say next is going to sound really crazy, but in terms of the money that was made or whatever it may be, maybe just reward players with in-game credits, right, instead, where they can go and purchase things in the marketplace, because hypothetically speaking, that would cost them nothing, right? So all the people that have purchased the game just get in-game credits. That would solve a problem. Again, all based on my opinion. I know majority of you guys might not like it, but I just have to say it, because when I no longer see the vision for the game, that's the worrying part. So I still support the devs, but I will 100% say they're still rooting in a complete wrong direction. But hey, we have to wait for the DLC still, I guess. I guess my point isn't valid until they release that first DLC. Now, regarding the Spider-Man problem, I didn't even know why it was a topic, but basically when, of course, Peter Parker swings past the Avengers Tower, apparently in the remastered version, he no longer says about the Avengers being on the West Coast, right? Now, it has actually been debunked. First of all, I don't even know why that would be a problem, because this game is not linked to, you know, Marvel's Avengers. It's not the same universe. But second of all, it has been confirmed by James Stevenson that that dialogue didn't change. It's just because the video that was posted by Greg Miller basically had a car chase going on and it interrupted the dialogue. So that's as far as that goes, but leave your thoughts on it in the comments below. Like I said, that's going to wrap up this video here. I'll see you in the next one, I guess. Till then, have yourselves a ridiculously amazing day. Try to just see my opinion on this and let me know if you just agree with me or not. Like, I mean, it's safe to say that I was definitely like a really, really super big fan of the game, and I still am, but now it's just, again, it's just like never ending. It's almost like leaks don't even feel exciting anymore to an extent, right? And there's still tons of that stuff happening, but that's kind of just how I feel. But guys, I'll see you in the next one. Till then, have yourselves a ridiculously amazing day, and adios amigos.